It's time to turn Canadian late night to 11. On today's show, from Our Lady Peace and Crash Karma, Mike Turner. From the East Coast, Alert the Medic, Troy Arsenault. With music from Chris Cadell and The Wreckage.
You know there's an elevator, right?
Live from the greatest country in the world, it's Stairway to 11. Now, here's your host, Noel Copeman.
It's a lot of stairs. It's a lot of stairs. Hi, Canada, and welcome to the Late Night Living Room. And as always, we're going to turn it up to 11 right away with our friends and yours, the greatest hair band in all of late night, Mr. Chris Cadell in The Wreckage.
And souls better look for hope on Sunday. I don't know where to go. A devil sneaking on my body. I get drunk but always broke. Can't find a woman that'll love me. I don't know where to go. Said I don't know where. And I wish I was a better man you could call a friend. I wish I hadn't wasted time. We could start again. And I hope it doesn't end tonight. Slipping through. Souls. Better look for hope on Sunday. I don't know where to go. A devil's taking on my money. I get drunk but always stoned. Can't find a woman that love me. I don't know where to go. Said I don't know where to go.
Show, did you write that one?
I did. I did write that one.
Hi, everybody, and welcome to Stairway to 11, the sweatiest show in late night. That's a lot of stairs, bud. That's a lot of stairs. Mr. Cadell, how are you, sir?
I'm feeling good.
You look good.
I didn't do the stairs. I took the elevator.
Yeah, tell me about it. Yeah, thanks. Yeah, something that could have been brought to my attention yesterday.
I thought you knew. I thought you knew.
Yeah, it's fine. Listen, man, you must be the busiest man in show business right now. You just got off the the road with Mr. Colin James out in the West Coast.
Yeah, it was great.
You're also the guitar player for Big Wreck.
I do that as well, yes.
And sometimes with Sass Jordan.
That's Jordan as well.
And sometimes with that.
Yeah, she's lovely.
I'm glad you brought the All-Star Band with you as well. Is that Derek Brady from the Sky Diggers over there?
That's me.
Right there.
Hi, buds. Good to see you. And the one and only Tony Rabolo.
That would be me also, Brady.
Yeah, from Lalo. And as well, you're jumping in, doing the Bedouin Sound Clash thing.
Yep, on road too, man.
I love it. Look at you guys. Good looking band.
Busy.
We should call you guys the Chris Cadell Quartet. You know, just
because
it's...
You know, because there's three.
Yeah, it's fine. Listen, we got a good show for you today. We have a great show for you tomorrow, but today's going to be delicious. We got John Lennon tomorrow.
What?
Yeah, I don't know how they did it. The tech people here are wizards. I'm pretty sure they're magical.
I know. I've witnessed it. It's amazing.
Yeah, it's great. Listen, during COVID, you and I needed to keep busy, so we both did a late night-esque style show.
Yeah.
And they went well.
Yeah, it was fun. It was a good...
Yours was great. It was lovely on Tuesdays. Is that what it is? Yes,
yeah, you had it on Tuesday. On Tuesday. Night. Yeah, it's still available on YouTube if you want to look back.
Stop promoting yourself, Chris. Listen,
what am I supposed to do?
The point of it was is that we think that that late night should be back here in Canada. We haven't had one for a long time, but we are a democracy, so anytime you need to do something like that, you got to go to the streets and find out what the people think. So we did just that. Hit it, guys. Would have seen that. We just had an avalanche come off of this building. What in the... We're doing some hazard shooting today out in Canada. We picked the best day to come out here and ask Canadians, do they love late night? Do they want to see late night in Canada, north of the 49th parallel once again? Sonia, are you a big fan of late night television?
I love late night television. In fact, I have done much television work with music.
Oh, what kind of music?
Well, I played drums in band from the 70s called the Crowbars.
The Crowbars, that's my favorite band.
Yes, we make a song called Oh, What a Feeling, Where's the Rush? Yeah.
Oh, is that your song?
Yes, I make drumming on that.
Oh, amazing. I sing that song in the shower every day. I will assume by the accent, are you from Canada? Were you born here?
No, I'm putting the accent on.
Oh, he's putting the accent on. Okay. Are you actually from here?
I was born at North York.
Do you think that Canada should bring a late night show back north?
Absolutely. Why not? I mean, like, the more entertaining content that I can flip through while I'm sitting on my couch, the better.
Absolutely. It's been too long.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Nope. Okay.
Because when the weather outside is weather.
Oh, all right. Well, what would be representative if you were to watch a Canadian late night show? What is it that you would want to see that makes you feel more Canadian?
Well, I think the most important thing is up-and-coming Canadian artists, to be honest.
Shania Twain.
I think it would be nice to see a show that celebrates, you know, all the work that, you know, Canadian actors, musicians are doing.
I happen to know one named Bianca Bernardi, and I'm her dad, and I was playing drums on...
So if Canada were to get a late night show, who do you think that you would like to host it?
Wow, that's a really good question. Geez, you put me right on the spot.
Does there need to be like a specific host? Like maybe we bring in like another Canadian icon weekly and we do like test them out.
There's a lot of actors, but definitely comedian.
Michael Bublé.
I don't know, like maybe start with Bublé and then bring in like, I don't know, like a Tate McRae.
Mike Bullard.
Cut. Theme songs. Let's just have an entire show about theme songs.
Crowbar.
Listen, I got to come clean. I had no idea that was Sonny Bernardi, the drummer from Crowbar. He put that on, and director Dave-O, this is his fault, off camera, they set that up. So I felt like a dummy, because I would have loved to have actually talked to him about it. Doesn't really matter. Whatever. Listen, this is a late night show. We've got some music. It's time to bring another great musician out, our very first guest. You know him. He's got Junos. He's got MMVAs. He's got millions of fans. He's got millions of cats. He has written four of the most important records that Canada will ever hear. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mr. Mike Turner.
one, do you?
A little.
Yeah.
It's a lot of D.
It's a lot of D.
D, and then we play some D, and then we're done.
There you go. It's been a little while since you've been on a late night show.
Yeah, it's been a minute.
Yeah, Conan, well, there's footage of it. When was the last time you were on an actual late night show then?
Probably 2000.
Ooh.
99, another millennia.
Well, it's been, what, 22 years since you left the illustrious band that you basically started. But then it was rather miraculous and rather cathartic that you found yourself back on stage with those guys after all those years. And you were literally on stage playing for 5 shows. And then as a hologram for the other ones, which is amazing.
Yeah, yeah. Your
Mike Turner circa 2056.
Yeah, my stand-in. He was good. He never made a mistake night amazing. After night. Just awesome.
You got to play Massey Hall for the first time.
Yes. Yeah.
OLP didn't play Massey, so how was that whole experience?
Well, OLP when I was in didn't play Massey, so it was really a great opportunity, and it was nice of the guys to invite me for the hometown show. So I came out and played a few songs, and it was amazing. I mean, Massey is such a storied venue. It was a great show.
Oh, so what's new since then? You've got a lot of stuff on the go.
A whole bunch of stuff. I mean,
yeah.
Up until COVID, I was producing and mixing and doing all the music things, and then I moved into mixing live recordings. And then COVID happened, and there were no more live recordings. So the last one I did was Mark Knopfler, and that was a totally fun thing. But then there was COVID. So there was a few things, like we all, like you said, we all kept ourselves amused, and I did a few things. And a friend who I ride motorcycles with said, "We're going to open a motorcycle shop. What do you think about being around motorcycles?" And I said, "You're distant and wearing a helmet. Yeah, this will work."
Oh, that's...
So it's called Flying Squirrel Motorcycle Club, and it's sort of a private member's thing for motorcycles.
Beautiful.
It's like a motorcycle club without all the law breaking and stuff.
I don't trust anything with two wheels, so that's I'll fair. Just hang outside and that's wave fair. From a distance. During those COVID years, Netflix showed quite a few of the what they would like to call unsuccessful festivals. Woodstock 99 being one of them, and OLP was there. I would love to get your perspective on how that whole thing came
about. It was, it's funny looking back, because I saw the documentary, and I was like, yeah, that's pretty much how it went, but it's a little bit of a drag to be reminded, you know, a career high spot in terms of the size of the crowd and everything. Cultural low point. Like, why did they have to go inside? But we knew that the morning of that we played, we all were out walking around the grounds, and it was just a ruin. It was not going to end well. So we made a point of playing our show, arrogantly playing a whole bunch of material nobody had ever heard. Awesome. And then we got on our bus and left.
Wow. Wow. That's the death of festivals right there. That's what it's all about.
Well, I mean, it wasn't as bad as that Firefest one. At least it actually happened.
Yeah, good point. Very good point. So. We've lost quite a few musicians that mean a lot to people mm-hmm. in the last couple of years. Eddie Van Halen being one of them. You guys were lucky enough to tour with Van Halen. And Mr. Eddie gave you a gift?
Yeah, Ed was the sweetest guy. It was kind of funny, because I'm English, so we're a little standoffish. I mean, the hug with you was difficult, but I went through it.
We had to go find a special tea for you as well.
But Ed was always a grab you and hug you and kiss you when he met you, you know, when he saw you again the next day. And it's like, oh, dude, I'm English. Don't do that. We're weird. But yeah, he gave me a couple of amps. Because he has his signature amps, and when the first one came in, he said, "Yeah, check it out." He's like an excited kid, and he's twisting knobs, and he's plugging a guitar, and so I'm plugging it and playing, and he's, this is the clean sound, and this is the, and I'm like, wait a second, Ed Van Halen is, guitar, you take the guitar.
Yeah.
I should not have a guitar around you.
Well, now that you've got his gear, you should be all just as good as him. Isn't that how that works? I'm pretty sure that's how that works.
No.
We'll find out. I'm pretty sure. Science is on that. We'll get back to you, but... Mm-hmm. You also shared the stage with fellas from Led Zeppelin.
Yeah.
Page and Plant. Not everybody gets to say they've done that.
Super weird.
I bet.
Not weird, but it was basically like...
what are we doing here?
Robert Plant heard Starseed and said, bring them to me. And more or less, we were shortly thereafter did 5 shows with him, I think. And it was awesome. I mean, he was such a gentleman, and it's Led Zeppelin in one form.
Amazing.
You know, when he walks up, was in catering, says, "Hello, I'm Robert." I'm like, you don't need to say that ever. Ever.
Yes.
But he chooses to, and that's what makes him such a gentleman.
Oh man, so many fans of Led Zeppelin. I love it. Mike, thanks for being here. We appreciate your time. You gonna hang out?
Why not? I got nothing else to do.
Perfect. Awesome. And you're going to know the next guest.
Amazing.
We've got Troy from Alert the Medic. He is the East Coast rocker, and we've got him coming after. He's zooming with us. He's zooming with us. We'll be right back. Hit it, Chris.
Troy Arsenault.
Troy, can you hear me? Troy,
a little more.
You can hear me?
I can hear you.
Okay, buddy. Good. Oh, I guess I need your cards. That's you and... Okay. Hi, Troy.
Hey, Noel.
How are you, buddy?
I'm good, man. I'm good.
Good.
You're looking good. Killing it.
Yeah. It'd be awesome if we were a month deep in this so that each one of these throws would actually make sense. All right.
Well, that's why you have practices.
Yeah. Practice makes perfect, right. But if no one's perfect, then why practice? What's the deal with practice? Beautiful. I'm so glad that you guys played that song, some big wreck going into break. Amazing.
Yeah, fun stuff.
Yeah, you're on tour with those guys quite a bit.
Yeah, we're going out into March.
Are you?
Just mostly around Toronto, so I wouldn't call it a tour, but
sure. At least you're out there doing some stuff.
Yeah, you got a bunch of gigs in a row, so.
Well, perfect.
Yeah, that's a tour.
And we're going to take that right there and add it to the segment that you had during your COVID show. Well, what's your beef?
What's your beef?
So more or less what I'm always saying is we're going to steal your segment, bud. That's more or less. You don't have to reinvent the wheel. You got to change the rims.
Yeah, just do it.
All right, you got a theme song for this?
We got a theme song for it.
All right, let's do What's Your Beef?
What's your beef? Yeah, what's your beef, man?
And that's it, eh? Okay, well, on this week's episode, what is the beef, Mr. Cadell?
Okay, so it's road beefs, right?
Yeah, touring edition.
Touring edition road beefs. And what happens to us on the road, we're in a van, you're in a bus, and you can't poop in either of those things.
That's very true.
You got to go on a poop safari. Yep. That's what I like to call it.
No, number two.
Poop safari. You don't know where it's going to happen. You don't know how. It's a gas station. It's Tim Hortons. It's whatever.
If you're lucky. Yeah.
But that's not really the beef. It's just one-ply toilet paper. Like, okay, there's been a lot of advancements in one-ply in the last little while. I don't really know the technology of it. But, you know, the really thin one that comes one-ply on the huge roll. And if it gets stuck at all, it just rips. Ugh.
It's like putting cotton candy in water and then it just kind of disintegrates.
It should be illegal. Yeah, it should be illegal. Like you can't get any of it off of the roll.
Now, Mike, did you guys have the same beef when you guys were out and about?
That's an eternal truth.
Yeah.
And you never know when you go on safari, opening the door, and there may be an urgent need, and you open the door and it's like that one in Train Spotting.
Yeah.
You're all doing that because you know the moment where you're like, and there's no escape.
Lake in the middle of it.
There's no escape.
Here we go.
I bear the trauma.
Yeah.
Bear the scars.
It's the worst.
We have another person via satellite right now that can jump in on this as well. We are now joined with Troy Arsenault, the guitar player from Alert the Medic, all the way out in Halifax. Troy, are you there? Can you hear me?
Sure can, Noel. How are you?
Oh, amazing. I'm glad technology works today. Awesome. How you doing, buddy?
I'm good. Just having a laugh at this segment.
Listen, you guys tour quite a bit, and whenever you come into the cities with actual populations, you got to travel quite a distance. What is your thought on one-ply toilet paper, my friend?
Oh, I still have the scars on my wrist. Like when you fight your hand to try to wheel it down from the top.
the blades.
The blades. Oh, man. It's a nightmare.
It's real, man.
Wow. Yeah, this is network television, everybody. This is what we talk about. The hard-hitting questions right here.
Everybody poops,
11.
Man. Everybody poops.
We'll get that theme song next time. Troy, listen, there's been a lot of things that have been going on in Toronto over the last 3 years, and unfortunately, the death of the music scene is one of them. We're not losing any seeds, but we're definitely losing the soil. Are you guys running into the same thing out in Halifax?
Yeah, the venues have taken a big hit. We used to have a real nice developing scene for original artists. We used to get on the backs of all you big bands from Toronto that would come on out. We'd be able to get to jump on and support and kind of also then support the bands that were younger than you. But right now you can go find tons of tribute bands. Seems like tribute cover bands, theme parties, they're doing well, but it's really hard to get people out the door right now and venues to kind of back the originality of things.
Well, it seems like the whole landscape has changed and bands now have to do some pretty interesting and miraculous things to be seen. You know, kind of like getting a WWF superstar to be in one of their promos. Let's take a look.
I address MySpace, all right? That's MySpace. What do you want? There you go. Here.
Amazing. Absolutely. How did you get Rick Martel to be a part of that?
Oh, our bass player, Matt, he used to do promotions and wrestling out east back in the early 2000s. So we were on tour going through, many provinces we go through. Matt seemed to know a wrestler in every one of them. And this one here met us at a Boston Pizza off the side of the highway. Told us a bunch of old war stories. And as we were leaving, he was like, why don't we do a bit? And we took two takes of that. And maybe one of the most viewed videos that we have.
Well, the other guys in that video are the other terrible actors, I guess, in that video are your bandmates, Alert the Medic. And you guys are doing some writing now, new stuff on the way?
yeah, we're excited. We've been demoing a little bit here since the beginning of 2023, and we're going to start tracking drums this week. So we have some new music coming here in probably mid to late spring.
Beautiful. Well, I'm sitting beside somebody that really enjoys your music as well. Yeah,
woo!
Mr. Mike Turner. Yeah. Troy, we love you, man.
Wouldn't be
thanks,
doing it without him.
There you go. Thanks for being here. Good luck on the new stuff. This is Troy from Alert the Medic. If you have not heard anything that they have done, please go to Spotify or Apple Music or wherever you go and listen to your music, or just come and get some of the vinyls on alertthemedic.com. Troy, we love you. Thank you very much for being here. And we'll be right back with
thanks,
more
guys.
Music from
in the
Bye,
middle
boss.
Of the floor.
I love you, buddy.
Hey.
Thanks
hey,
you for...
stay there for a sec, Noel.
Oh, hold on, hold on. Let me go back into my light.
Just for you.
Yeah, exactly.
Your light here.
Your next
hold on,
stop,
so,
please.
Yeah.
There you go.
What a ridiculous
thing. Making TV in Canada. Nice.
No, no, no. We'll get a, a group shot at the end, Dave.
Yeah, make sure you send me a pretty one.
Because I'm going to want pictures with these guys and enter. Boz, are you leaving? Boz, are you going to leave?
And this is on you, Josh.
Boz, can you hang around for a hot second so that we can get a...
Yeah, I'll hang out.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. Thanks, buddy.
Check the show.
I'm enjoying this.
Yeah. No one's going to go quickly to that mark.
Yep. Okay. Just like what we did yesterday.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you want me to hit the mark before I start talking to you?
That's up to you. Feel the force.
Okay.
2 minutes.
Get ready to live.
Ideally, I'd want to see your face.
Right. Okay. Okay. So I'll just get my hustle on, so at least we can
stop. Not far after.
I mean, feel free to talk ahead.
Hey,
Dave. As long as I can see your face.
Okay. Okay. Cool.
You got it, buddy.
I hope so. We'll get it. It'll be better tomorrow. Don't worry. It's fine. We'll be better tomorrow.
Follow me on OnlyFans if you want.
So.
I better get a shout out for that tie that I tied.
A shout out. More like a shut up. Oh, sure.
Yeah.
Good day.
it. That's all. Thank you very much for watching. We love you. We're going to leave you with one more from Chris Goodell and the Wreckage. Keep being Canadian to each other, guys, and we'll see you tomorrow.
You done nothing but make me wait. Stop lying to me, lady.